your enemies.
And at every level, when Abel is victorious and represents God's will, then God's providence moves forward. So the Messiah also comes as the highest Abel, in a sense, at war. Jesus came 2,000 years ago, he came as the highest Abel for mankind. East and west,
here we are again, Speaker's Corner, London. It's not much, we know, but it's something. We have the freedom to get up here, although there aren't any soapboxes if you're looking for them, and say what we want, more or less. We have great freedom. And Nicholas and I, Nicholas has got a camcorder, we choose to exercise that freedom. So in case no one does, I'd like to welcome you to Speaker's Corner, London. It might be a joke, it might be a place of free entertainment, it might be a place to come and throw peanuts at the monkeys, meaning of course laugh at the loonies. Nicholas and I have both been detained under mental health act, so guilty as charged. But as has been said by a compatriot of mine, a great psychiatrist, and one or two of them are worth a shit. By and large, psychiatrists are the dregs of medical school, but R.D. Lang, I think it was him who said, and you won't mind if I paraphrase him, he said going mad was a healthy reaction to the insane world, or worse to that effect. And it is a crazy world where we're still burning up fossil fuels and giving our own kids asthma, where patents to alternative energy, free energy systems, have been held in the hands of a small cabal, a financial elite, who together with the Jewish banking fraternity have this dream of a new world order, and they're carving up the world in their image. And unfortunately for us, their pyramid scheme requires a greatly reduced human population, and they've come up with all sorts of ideas to reduce the human population. War, of course, that's always a good one, but the difficulty for them is that wars might go nuclear, and nuclear weapons don't differentiate. As it happens, by the way, depleting uranium. Spirit Guide Matthew calls it depleting uranium because it destroys the body's immune system. Depleted uranium doesn't differentiate either between members of the British Armed Forces and Iraqi civilians, between members of the Israeli Defense Forces and their enemies. So if you get that stuff in you, you're in trouble. But it's what they deserve. When I look at continental United States of America and I see the tornadoes coming in, the hurricanes, the earthquakes, the fires, these are the elementals rising up in obedience to God. Because the world's only superpower is God, Allah, Jehovah. The US has military bases all across this earth, devouring the world, causing trouble everywhere. Is it not a beautiful irony that the Americans should have helped to depose Colonel Gaddafi? Now, I've said before, Colonel Gaddafi was no Boy Scout, but he did a lot of good with the oil revenue for his people. Hillary Clinton, the US Secretary of State, said, "We came, we saw, he died." Watch that effect and laugh. It's on the internet. I bet Hillary Clinton isn't laughing when she attends the funeral of the US ambassador to Libya, killed in of all places, Benghazi. Colonel Gaddafi, we were all told, said that there were rats in Benghazi and they had to be rooted out. Well, given the way they behaved at the US embassy, maybe Colonel Gaddafi knew better than ourselves and the French how his people are. It's underneath all of this is tribalism. And indeed, since Colonel Gaddafi was summarily executed, there's been all sorts of tribal conflict and internecine fights and settlements with a heavily armed population. And make no mistake, we're helping to arm the so-called Syrian Free Army, whatever it is. Journalists, Western journalists have been there, have testified. It's not in the mainstream media much, but certainly in internet, But these Syrians are not Syrians. They're foreign mercenaries sent in there to cause trouble. We can think of, they give us all the catalogue of Gaddafi's crimes, Lockerbie. Gaddafi had nothing to do with Lockerbie. Lockerbie was an internal dispute within the CIA. You think they won't blow an airliner up? CIA have admitted that they've destroyed entire airplanes just to kill one person on board. That's been admitted. You should pay attention to these whistleblowers. CIA whistleblower saw the papers, all the documents from Roswell. It was an extraterrestrial craft that crashed. They didn't retrieve extraterrestrial biological entities. They did experiment on them.
How do you know
that? It's well tested because I trust these CIA whistleblowers. You can say cynically he's got a book to sell or he's trying to get attention. Those are two viable and plausible motives.
What are the cover-ups in terms of extraterrestrials?
Well, it's not widely known, except in the New Age movement, that the ETs came here to offer peace, because the big scare for them, as it should be for us, was the development of the atomic bomb, nuclear weapons. Spirit guys have explained that the hydrogen bomb is incredibly dangerous because apparently it can could theoretically rip the fabric of space. Space isn't entity, space is a material, which used to be called ether. Albert Einstein, quite apart from his plagiarism, Albert Einstein rewrote this, one of his papers, either the general theory or the special theory, to fit in with the prevailing orthodoxy, the prevailing fashion of that day, which was that there was no ether. However, the Michelson-Morley experiment, right, which apparently concluded there was no ether, well, that's one possible conclusion, but how about that the experiment was too badly designed, too crude to detect such a fine material? Space isn't empty. And someday, humanity, as it becomes, will have the potential to use this material to travel vast distances as our space brothers do at the moment. They came in the offered peace to our humanity which had developed these dangerous implements. And apparently the US did a deal with what are called the Little Greys. And from the Little Greys, they got the microchip, which we all enjoy, of course. They got their stealth bomber and everything else. And the US suddenly became what they fashioned themselves to be, the world's only superpower. However, as I pointed out earlier, the elementals, the spirits of the air, earth, water and fire, are very active in exercising God's judgment. And sure enough, the US is having an enormous amount of trouble with hurricanes, fires, floods, and so forth. The insurance industry in the US must be absolutely straining. It really must. And they deserve it. Mitt Romney, taking to become the US president, is going to repeal Obamacare. Obamacare itself was a compromise, of course. It's Dennis Kucinich. Dennis Kucinich is my idea. If I was American, I was inclined to vote Democrat. Let's say my dad was a steel worker in Pittsburgh. I'd be inclined to vote Democrat if it was black. I would definitely be inclined to vote Democrat. I'd vote for Dennis Kucinich. Dennis Kucinich wants universal health care, something which most of the rest of the civilized world already has. But if my dad was a self-made millionaire, I might be inclined to vote Republican. Well, my idea of Republican is Dr. Ron Paul. You see, we do have choices, real choices, but in between us and the politicians are the media. How hypocritical of today's Murdoch press to be outraged that pictures of a topless Catherine are published in France. How hypocritical of the Murdoch papers. The trouble is, ladies and gentlemen, we do believe we read. And if you're going to read these papers and be influenced by them, and you might think you're not, and you might think advertising doesn't influence you, next time in the supermarket, have a look what's in your basket. Right? Of course advertising works, the media definitely works, right? But there's alternative media through the internet, you can inform yourself. However, even the alternative media can't be relied upon because much of that is pushing fear, negativity. I listen to Alex Jones Radio, Oh, Alex Jones in Montour, Texas. It's all negative. Alex Jones cannot think of a single good thing to say about Barack Obama. He said, the media told us the catalogue of crimes by Colonel Gaddafi. Lockerbie, nothing wrong with it. Woman police constable Yvonne Fletcher in St. James's Square. Ladies and gentlemen, I saw a compelling documentary on television which made the case that Yvonne Fletcher was shot from an entirely different angle, right, deliberately shot dead from an office subsequently shot to be rented by the CIA. It's called Winning Hearts and Minds. If you're going to launch an attack in Libya from British air bases, you need the British people on board. So you do something outrageous, like deliberately murder an unarmed woman police constable to get outraged. You see, this is how these people really think. This is how they really operate. There's no special relationship. The United States would shit on this island if it needed to for its own interests. And if the United States thinks Israel is an ally, they need to look a little deeper into 9/11. Right? The whole world's built on lies, everywhere we look. Religion, so much lies. Science is full of lies. Economics, lies. Education, everything's built on false premises. Of course, you may notice, ladies and gentlemen, the debates between the Muslims and the Christian speakers are a little animated, more heated this Sunday, because there's been published on the net this anti-Islam film. Right? Well, again, I wish our Muslim friends would think a little before they overreact and realize that they're being manipulated by somebody. Manipulated to give these precise reactions. I have said, or I've indicated earlier, that there's a kind of irony, there's a kind of tragic justice in the ambassador being killed, not that I support the death of anyone, in Benghazi. See, as people have said, if Gaddafi was still there, that wouldn't have happened. Let's remember that Colonel Gaddafi condemned outright the atrocity of 9/11. But there are many Americans when polled in the streets, something like 40%, 30%, a fairly large number of Americans, they think Iraq was connected to 9/11. Iraq, Saddam Hussein had nothing to do with 9/11. Saddam Hussein, like Colonel Gaddafi, was very concerned about the Al-Qaeda. How is it that Americans, supposedly having created this enemy, Al-Qaeda, or Alex Jones would call Al-Qaeda, how is it they're now aiding and abetting Al-Qaeda to overthrow Assad? What are his place to praise? You know, but Saddam Hussein gassed the people, the Kurds, I think it was. But let's be fair, the Iraqis didn't invent these chemical weapons and they didn't manufacture them. They merely bought them. You notice when Saddam Hussein was in trial, he wasn't charged with that offence, even though it was all over the media, incessantly. Why not? Because his co-defendants might have had to be powerful economic Western interests in the petrochemical industries and the politicians that are affiliated to them. Certainly Germany. Modern Germany is involved in the sale of these weapons to Saddam Hussein. Isn't it amazing that the reaction to the atrocity at Aurora in Colorado, where a guy dyed his hair apparently, went into a cinema and shot up as many of the cinema goers? And by the way, who is it takes a six-year-old kid to a midnight movie to something as dark and violent as Batman? The whole American culture is inured with violence. The television is filled with images of violence. The movies are incredibly violent, apart from the few Jennifer Aniston rom-coms. Incredibly violent. The whole culture is geared up to violence. They think violence solves problems. And here they go, rampaging across the earth with their violence. Both the Russians and the Chinese have said, and it may only be rhetoric, but they've said they're drawing a line in the sand over Iran. President Obama might be convinced because he's backtracked on the support of Netanyahu and Israel. Netanyahu and Obama are fighting loggerheads. There's an allegation on the internet, which may have no basis in reality. It's an allegation that Netanyahu's trying to bring down Obama. Certainly, Governor Romney, when he met Netanyahu, was shitting himself. I said here at the corner, look how frightened he is. I said to people, go and watch the pictures tonight. Except he didn't show the pictures again, because if I could see Governor Romney was crapping his pants next to the gangster Netanyahu, well, certainly you could, right? They didn't show the pictures again, just a little banner on across the bottom of the screen. The Governor Romney has given the Israelis a blank check. He can do anything and it's okay by him. So people who think Obama's bad news, you might not like the President Romney. Luckily for us, Spirit Guide Matthew has said that Obama wouldn't be elected. Obama needs to have some courage and to move towards the peace that he deeply favours. Certainly the move to reduce the nuclear arsenals, which may have been initiated by the Russians, doesn't matter who started it, it's a good move. A world with less nukes is a safer world. This whole business of standing armies and going and invading, talking to tears that we don't like, that don't buy our goods and so forth, that is a violation of international law. Of course, the United Kingdom proved they can violate international law when invading Iraq. We can't complain when we see a further erosion of the international order. Supposedly they built this new world order. But those people at the top are the better of it. They're failing. Their schemes are dying in front of them. And they ain't going to help because humanity is awakening, rising up, informing itself, realizing that we have powers latent within us. The Jesus that they shout cliches about every week, he said, the things I do, ye shall do also. He said, know ye not that ye are gods? Don't mention that little bit. That's what the answer. Well, that's what the guy actually said. Well, men of peace, like Jesus, like John Lennon, have always been opposed by this warmongering culture. And the biggest warmonger on the surface of this planet is Uncle Sam Land. Just this. Luckily, China's coming up strong. Sooner or later, China and the US will have to slog it out. I hope we've got the good sense to stay out of it. Israel, thank you for listening. May God bless you. I'm going to invite Nicholas to speak.
Oh, the Speaker's Corner. New Age is happening, and those of you that come to listen to me will be safe from the Third World War, and you will live happy lives. The Jews have got their state, and being the Nazis that half Israel is, I've always supported the Palestinian people. And I think part of the spiritual war on the United States of America will be a massive war on all the American people. I believe this is right, and I believe that the more Americans die in a flame of hell, the better for the rest of us on this side of the Atlantic Ocean. America is not a peaceful nation. It's a motherfucking cowboy nation. Although they produced a lot of goods and services, there was a certain doctrine way back in the early 20th century that talked about America cleaning up its backyard. You Muslims better get real. For what? Saudi Arabia and Israel have always waged war, and we are seeing the mother of all holocausts that is the Middle East. This is not happening for nothing. This is policy and was decided by the Warburg dynasty as far back as 1927 to 29. Remember Korea? You lost that war. Remember Vietnam? You lost that war. And those people aren't Muslim. Ho Chi Minh. A couple of years ago, I think it was, I met an American airman. Didn't want to talk about Nam. And now Vietnam is a sovereign, sort of pseudo-communist republic. And the good news is China is going to challenge the United States of America. The problem is that the Chinese and Japanese have a bit of antagonism. I knew this was going to happen. They want to spread the war into the ocean of peace, known as the Pacific Ocean. Japan has done a lot for humanity. All of us have something at home, made in Japan, the world's leading car manufacturer, Toyota. Say goodbye to Ford. More unemployment in America. Vote for which fucking sucker you like, you dumbass Americans. Nothing will change in your country until you reveal and expose, as we are doing, the Illuminati control. I believe that Hillary Clinton is evil. I believe that woman is pure evil. And her and her cock-sucking, democratic, elected Clinton, Hillary Clinton and William Jefferson Clinton, stitched up Arkansas. We know all about the drugs deals. That is the American capitulation. And the good news is that millions of Americans are dying of drugs. Black and white. And the Nation of Islam is right to attack white America. Long live Louis Farrakhan, who I respect. And as America hits the deck, China rises, the mighty Oriental force. Military maneuvers. More of the karmic payback for Hiroshima and Nagasaki. We wouldn't be here if Fukushima had gone AWOL. Japanese made a big mistake building their nuclear power stations. They are actually more dependent on nuclear power than oil. But the good news is the Japs are doing business with our brothers and sisters in Iran, because Japan is turning against America. Konnichiwa, Japan. We ask you to make an alliance with China and let us all face America. Let the Muslims die in their millions, because they want it. While they submit, America will fall. And unfortunately, Muslims in America, who make up the American people, will die. Allah takes no sides as the Third World War hits the fan. Thank you for listening.
For those of you who can imagine that there's UFOs, that other beings who haven't had our setbacks, like Atlantis, are here to help us, then the ETs tell us through their channels that they've got complete inventory on all nuclear weapons on this planet. They can switch off the nukes. They can take nuclear weapons out of the 3D matrix. They've got awesome powers, but of course they have to have the say-so of the Most High, of the Holy One, of the Source, which people call God or Allah. Most often it's Speaker's Corner. They're here at the invitation of God, because Mother Earth has been suffering from the greed of the few. We never think of all these explosions that are detonated in the mantle of the Earth. We never thank, how many times we thank the Mother of the Earth for giving you the food that you ate today, and tomorrow, and the day, and yesterday. We take things for granted. Notice the drought in America. That's the fire element that's burnt up the crops, and food prices are going to have to rise. That's going to be more hardship for the Americans. You know, I wish the president, whether it's Obama or Bush or whoever, I wish they would stop saying God bless America, because it only infuriates God. It is not possible for God to bless America when it commits these crimes all across this world. You're not guilty of these crimes. You are hapless bystanders like me. Don't take sides. Find peace within. And have faith in a better future. And know, most importantly, that the death of your body is not the end of you. No matter what the theories of science are today. Christopher Hitchens lives on. First to his surprise. Richard Dawkins will confound himself in due course. Realise what a pile of shit he published those books. Charles Darwin has admitted through a medium that he was largely wrong. not let religion control you, don't let science control you either. Right? Control yourself, your own thoughts, your own life. And I hope it's a good one.